Good morning to all of you. So today I will tell you about the chapter number 5, which is related with lines and angles. And this chapter is very interesting, as you see on my left hand side and right hand side, some teaching aids are there related with some geometrical concept and pairs of angles, and some diagrams are also on the white blackboard. So I think you are thinking about some diagrams and you are very much aware about these diagrams. If you see these diagrams, all these diagrams we are using in our daily routine, in our surrounding area also. So it may be one question arising in your mind, is today's chapter is related with which concepts? If you see these diagrams, in all these diagrams, some points are there, some lines are there, some line angle, some line segments are there, and some angles are there. If you see this diagram, we can say these are two angles. So today's chapter is related with line and angles. In this chapter, we will deal with different types of lines. It may be line, line segment, ray, and different types of angles. How can we represent these angles? What is the meaning of line? What is the meaning of line segments? How can we represent line segments? So I will tell each and everything to all of you. If you see in this teaching aids, it is given here line, line segments, ray, and some more points related with perpendicular lines, parallel lines. And if you see in this teaching aids, there are some angles related with adjacent angles, linear pair, vertical opposites, corresponding angles, alternate angle, and interior adjacent angles. These all things we will learn in this chapter. So first we will go through with the introduction part of this chapter, line and angles. As I told, if you see these diagrams, some line segments are there. If you see here, if we denotate this point as A, this point as B, C, D, E, and F, then what we will say about AB? What is AB, what is BC, what is CD? Sometimes we are saying sides or edges. Okay, it is sides or edges, but some other names are there. The chapter is related with lines and line segments. So we can see what is AB, what is BC. So today we will deal with this. If you see these diagrams, if we mark here A, B, C, D. So one question may be in your mind, what is AB? AB is line or line segment, and if it is line, then why it is line? So these type of questions I think are moving in your mind. If you see, this is the shape of a hut in which some windows are there. If you mark here P, Q, R, S, so which type of geometrical concept this is? So today we will go with that. So first we will start with the introduction part of this chapter, line and angles. So first we will start with one diagram. For example, if we draw a line, and this is P point and this is Q point. If we say this is our P point and this is our Q point, then what is PQ? We can say PQ is a line segment. It has two endpoints and it can be represented by PQ bar. So this is the diagram of line segment. If you see in this teaching aids, it is written here, line segment means it is a part of a line. It has two endpoints and it has fixed length. So this type of diagram is known as line segment and it is represented by PQ bar. If we extend these points in both the direction endlessly, or you can say we will take one more figure. This is again another example of line segment. If we extend in both the direction endlessly, then we can say this is the diagram of line and it can be represented by AB and just above the AB you will write arrow. So as you see here, the definition of line is set of continuous points which extends indefinitely, as I said, endlessly in both the direction. If you see in left hand direction of A, in the right hand side direction of B. So we can say, what is the meaning of line? Is set of continuous points which extend indefinitely. It has only length, no width and no end points. We will extend on in both the directions. So this is the minor difference between line segment and line. Now we will come to the next point. If we are saying this is our end point and we will extend only in right hand side direction, and we take one more point here, that is your X point, and this is your OX. So this is the concept related with ray, and it is represented by OX, and we will write here arrow. So this is the concept of ray. As you see in this teaching aids, what is the meaning of ray? We can say a part of a line which has one end point, as you see only one end point, that is O, it moves indefinitely in one direction. So we will extend this line only on one direction, that is the right hand side. It has indefinite length, so we will extend this line endlessly. So we can say OX is here ray. So this is the difference between line segment, line and ray. So I think this concept is very very important, because the students are facing difficulty what is the difference between line segment, line and ray. So I hope with the help of these three diagrams it is clear to all of you how can we represent line segment, line and ray. After this we will come to on angles. What is the meaning of angles? How can we will represent the angles? Because the name of the chapter is line and angles. So after this we will continue with angles. So as you know very well, whenever two line segments are intersect each other, or you can say if we are taking one triangle, this is A, B and C. If we see AB and BC, both are line segments. Why both are line segments? Because AB has two endpoints and BC has also two endpoints. Same for CA, we can say it has two endpoints. And as per the definition of line segment, we know very well if a side, or if you can say AB has two endpoints, it is the concept of line segment, as I told earlier. So if we see here AB and BC, both are intersecting at B point. So one angle will generate, this is the angle. So we can say this is our angle ABC, and it is represented by angle ABC, and this is the symbol of angle. We can say this is the symbol of angle. We also can say that BC and CA, both are line segment intersecting at point C. So one more angle will generate, that is BCA. Same we can say AC and AB, both are line segment intersecting at A point. So one more angle will generate, that is BAC. We can say it is also written as CAB. So in this triangle we can say three line segments are there, AB, BC and CA, and three angles are there, as I told, angle ABC, angle BCA and angle BAC, or we can say angle CAB. So this is the concept of angles. So whenever line segments are intersecting each other, some angle will generate. One more diagram I want to tell you related with angles. If you see here, these two lines, these are lines intersecting each other at point O. If we are taking this line as AB, this is as CB, then we can say angle AOD. Then this is the another angle, angle BOD. This is the another angle, we can say angle BOC, and this is the another angle, angle COA. So whenever these lines are intersecting each other at point O, four angles will generate. We can say this is first angle, this is second one, this is third one, and this is fourth one. So the value of angle AOD is equivalent to 1, or we can say angle 1. Same for the others. So this is the concept of angles. So I hope with the help of this explanation, it is very much clear to all of you ki what is the meaning of line and what is the meaning of angles. In this chapter, we will deal with different types of lines and angles. Now we will continue with our next concept, that is related angles. As you see here, it is already written, in related angles we will deal with complementary angle, supplementary angle, adjacent angles, linear pair, and vertically opposite angle. So first we will come to on complementary angles. So what is the meaning of complementary? So as you know very well, the concept of angles, I think it is clear to everyone. So what is the meaning of complementary? So for example, if I am taking one angle, this is angle A, B, C, and this is equivalent to 30 degree. Or if I am saying angle A, B, C equals to 30 degree, this angle can also be written as M, angle ABC. So what is the meaning of M? M is related with measurement. So what is the measurement of this angle? The measurement of this angle is 30 degree. Now we will come to again this point. What is the meaning of complementary? If angle ABC is 30 degree, then how can we will identify complements angle? So the meaning of complementary angles is if the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degree, or we can say if the measures of two angles is equal to 90 degree, that type of pairs of angles is known as complementary angle. So if this angle is 30 degree, then we will take one more angle, that will be the complement angle of this angle. Complement angle of angle ABC, and how can we will calculate 90 degree minus 30 degree, it becomes 60 degree. It means the complement angle of this angle is equals to 60 degree, and we will make one more angle, it look like this. We can say this is PQR, this is equals to 60 degree. So if you see here, 30 degree plus 60 degree, it becomes 90 degree. So we can say this pairs of angles, this pairs of angle is known as complementary angles. If sum is not equal to 90 degree, then we can say that is, or that pair of angles is not related with complementary angles. So what is the meaning of complementary angle? If the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degree or exact 90 degree, then we can say that pair of angles is known as complementary angles. Now we will come to the next angle, that is supplementary angle. The next angle is supplementary angle, or supplementary angles because it is related with pairs. Supplementary angles. So if the measures of two angles is equal to 180 degree or exact 180 degree, that type of pair of angles is known as supplementary angle. For example, if I am taking one angle, this is your angle related with 50 degree, and I am marking here, this is your PQR. So if I am saying measurement of angle PQR, this is related with 50 degree, then what is supplement angle? So how can we calculate supplement angle? In that case, we can say supplement angle, this is equals to 180 degree minus 50 degree, it becomes 130 degree. And how can we make 130 degree? As you know very well, with the help of protractor, we will make it easily. So this is the angle related with 130 degree, and it is related with x, y and z. And when you will add 130 degree and 50 degree, it becomes 180 degree. It means this pair of angles P, Q, R and x, y, z are related with supplementary angles because their sum is equivalent to 180 degree. So this is the concept of supplementary angles. Now we will come to the next point, that is adjacent angles. So how can we will define adjacent angle? If you see, I am making one diagram. This is A, B, C, and this is your common arm D. So if we are see here, two angles are there. One is angle CBD, angle CBD, and angle DBE. BD is the common arm and B is the common vertex. This B is the common vertex for both the angles. If you see here, B is the common point here, B is also common point. So what is the condition of adjacent angles? How can we will identify if the given diagram is related with adjacent angles or not? So if you see here, it is written here in the stitching aids. What is the meaning of adjacent angles? You see here another diagram and it is written two angles having common vertex and one common arm and the other two arms are on opposite sides of the common arm. So that is different diagram, but if you see in this diagram, BD is the common arm and B is the common vertex, and if you see BC and BA, both are non-common arm which are lie opposite sides of this common arm BD. I repeat it again, if you see in this diagram, this angle, if you denote this angle as 1 and this angle 2, we can say this is the diagram related with adjacent angles because both the angles have only one vertex, that is the common vertex, and common arm is BD. And if you see BA and BC, both are non-common arm which are lie opposite sides of that common arm BD. So this is the concept of adjacent angles. It means in adjacent angles we want one common vertex, common arm and two non-common arms which are lie opposite sides of common arm BD. After this adjacent angle, we will come to the next angle, and the next angle is related with linear pair. So linear pair diagram is also given here in this stitching aids. If you see here, this type of diagram, I will again make here. This is your 135 degree and this is your 45 degree. If I am taking here A, O, B and this is your C. So if we see here, OC is also a common arm. Why it is common arm? Because it is related with angle BOC as well as it is related with angle AOC, and O is the common vertex. So can we say angle AOC and BOC are adjacent angles? Definitely we can say. So what is the meaning of linear pair? The meaning of linear pair means it includes only two angles. As you see in this diagram, angle BOC and angle AOC, and their sum becomes, or their sum must be equivalent to 180 degree. This is the main condition for the linear pair. It includes two angles, both angles should be adjacent angles. It means one common arm is there. As you see in this figure, OC is the common arm, O is the common vertex, and OA and OB both are non-common arm which are lie opposite sides of common arm OC. So we can say the sum of these two angles, if we add these two angles, what will sum becomes 135 degree plus 45 degree it becomes 180 degree. So this type of diagram or this type of concept is known as linear period, in which the sum of two angles are equivalent to 180 degree and both the angles should be adjacent angles. After this, we will continue with one more angle, that is vertically opposite angle. So if you see in the stitching aids, this is the diagram related with vertically opposite angles. So I am explaining here, if two lines are intersecting each other, as you see here, our concept is vertically opposite angle. If two lines AB and CD intersecting at point O, so some angle will generate. For example, this is your angle 1, this is your angle 2, this is your angle 3, and this is your angle 4. So in this concept, we can say angle AOD is equivalent to angle BOC. It means angle 1 is equivalent to angle 3. And we can say angle BOD, this is equal to angle AOC. It means angle 2 is equivalent to angle 4. And this O point is known as point of intersection. I repeat it again, whenever two lines are intersecting each other at a point O, then some angles will generate. As you see in this figure, angle AOD is vertically opposite to angle BOC, so both will be equal. It means their measurement will be equal, their value will be equal. Same for angle BOD and angle COA, both are vertically opposite, so their measurement will be equal. That's why we can say angle 1 is equivalent to angle 3 and angle 2 is equivalent to angle 4, and this is the concept of vertically opposite angle. Now we will come to on the next concept, that is pair of lines. It includes intersecting lines, parallel lines, transversal, and then angle made by a transversal. So we will come to on next concept, that is pair of lines, and it includes first concept, intersecting line. So as I told earlier, what is the meaning of intersecting line? If two lines are intersect each other, it may be in this way. If you see, this is the line PQ and this is your RS line. Both are intersecting at a point. We denote this point as M. So this type of diagram or this type of concept of line is known as intersecting line. As you see here, PQ and RS both are intersecting at a point M. We can say this M point is known as point of intersection. Now we will come to the next point, parallel lines. Opposite of intersecting line. So how can we will draw the parallel lines? This is the next concept. So if the lines are not intersecting each other, then we can say, so if you see in this diagram, this is line PQ and this is line RS. If we see These two lines are parallel to each other, and if you see their length between the line is fixed. This is the distance between this line to next line, PQ line to RS line. So we can say PQ line is parallel to RS. This is the symbol of parallel. They are never intersecting each other, and the distance between one line to another line is fixed. Now we will come to the next concept, that is transversal. So how can we will define transversal? Which type of diagram is related with transversal? in this concept, for example, if we are taking one line related with L and another line we will take M, then how can we will draw transversal line? So if a line intersecting these two parallel lines in such a way, if we denoted this line as N, so this is your P point, this is your Q point. So if we see here, L and M both are parallel, and one line is there, that is the N line, which intersecting the L and M line at P and Q points, then some angle will generate. If you see here, different types of angles are there. Near about, if you see, 8 angles are generated when a transversal line intersecting two parallel lines. If we extend it and with one more line, or denoted by, you can say, R. So if L is parallel to M and M is parallel to R, then we can say this transversal line and intersecting these three lines, L, M and R, at the point P, Q and S, again some angle will generate. So as per this diagram, we can say N is a transversal line, L is parallel to M and M is parallel to R, as you see here. So this is the concept of transversal. After this, we will continue with one more concept, the angle made by a transversal. So in this concept, there are various angles, as you see in the stitching aids, alternate angles, corresponding angles, interior adjacent angles. So that are the part of this concept, angle made by a transversal. As you see the diagram of alternate angles here, corresponding angles, interior adjacent angles. So I am explaining these things here. So angle made by a transversal. So under this concept, first we will draw two parallel lines. This is line L and this is line M. The first condition is L is parallel to M. Now we will take one more line that is known as a transversal, and this is P line. As you know very well, whenever transversal line intersect the parallel lines, some angle will generate. As you see here, these are four angles. Again, four angles will generate here. This is first, second, third, fourth. Again, we will denote here 5, 6, 7, 8. So with the help of this diagram, how can we identify which angles are known as vertically opposite angles, which angles are alternate interior angles, what is the role of transversal here, because L is parallel to M. So if we see here, this transversal line intersecting L and M lines at these points. So we can say in this diagram, angle 1 is equivalent to angle 3 due to vertically opposite angle. We can say also angle 2 is equivalent to angle 4, angle 5 is equivalent to angle 7, and angle 6 equals to angle 8. These all are equal angles due to only one reason, that is vertically opposite angle. As you see here, 1 and 3 both are vertically opposite angles of each other. Same for angle 2 and 4. Then you will come here, angle 5 and angle 7 and angle 6 and 8. So we can say, as per concept of vertically opposite angles, these angles are equal to each other. After vertical opposite angles, we will come to on interior angles. What is interior angles? How can we describe interior angle as per this diagram? So what is interior angles? Then I will tell you, first I will tell you interior angles, then exterior angles. So if you see angle 3, 4, 5 and 6, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. All these four angles lie between the line L and M. That's why these four angles are known as interior angles. Now the question arises, how can we build describe exterior angle? So as you see in this diagram, there are four exterior angles, angle 2, angle 1, angle 7 and angle 8. These four angles not lie between the line L and M. All these four angles, angle 1, 2, 7 and 8 lie above the line L, if you see here, and these two angles lie below the line M. That's why these are not the part of interior. That's why it is known as exterior angle. So this is the difference between interior and exterior angles. Now we will come to on adjacent angles. If you see in this diagram, how can we will define, how can we will show adjacent angle if we denote this point as A and we denote this point as B, then definitely we can say angle 1 and angle 2 both are adjacent angles because both are near to each other with one common arm, that is if we denote here B, here C and D, and this is my M and this is my N, then we can say AB is a common arm and AC and AD both are non-common arm as per the concept of adjacent angles. So we can say angle DAB, that is equivalent to angle 1 or angle 2, both are adjacent angles, and if we see their sum becomes, both are adjacent angles, so their sum becomes 180 degree. Same for angle 3 and 4, angle 5 and angle 6, angle 7 and angle 8, these are adjacent angles. Now we will come to the next point, that is alternate interior angle. Alternate interior angles. So interior means, as I told earlier, angle 3, 4, 6 and 5, these are interior angle. But this time we are talking about alternate interior angle. So if you see, my shape is there, that is related with Z. And I mark here, this is the shape of Z. So angle 3 and angle 5, both are interior angle, or we can say both are alternate interior angle because one shape is there, that is the shape of Z. Same procedure we will say for angle 4 and angle 6 because again one Z shape is generated here. So angle 4 is equivalent to angle 6. So we can say alternate interior angles in this diagram is angle 3 equals to angle 5 and angle 4 equals to angle 6 due to this Z shape. Now we will come to on the next concept which is correlated with this, alternate exterior angle. So under this heading we have to identify alternate exterior angle. So if you see here, again Z shape is there and we are talking about exterior angle, it means angle 1, 2, 7 and 8. So we can say angle 1 is equivalent to angle 7 and angle 2 is equivalent to angle 8. As you see here, again Z shape is there in both the directions. So these angles are related with alternate exterior angle, or we can say angle 1 is equivalent to angle 7 as per this diagram and angle 2 is equivalent to angle 8. Now we will come to corresponding angle. The next concept is related with corresponding angle. So if we see angle 2 and angle 6, angle 2 and angle 6 both are equal with the property of corresponding angle. Why? Because angle 2 lie above the line L and angle 6 are also lie above the line M. So both are equal. It means we also can say angle 3 equals to angle 7. If you see here, angle 3 lie above the line, lie below the line L, and angle 7 lie below the line M. So both are equal. It is in left hand side. Same we will do in right hand side. It means we can say angle 1 equals to angle 5, angle 4 equals to angle 8. It means these angles are equal due to corresponding angle property. After this, we will come to one more important property that is related with interior angles lie on the same transversal line. Interior angles lie on the same transversal line. If you see here, angles 3 and 6 both are interior angles, so we can say when we will add these two angles, angle 3 plus angle 6, their sum becomes 180 degree, and this is the concept of supplementary. So we can say 3 plus 6, angle 3 plus 6 is equivalent to 180 degree because both are interior angles and both are lie on the same sides of a transversal line P. It means we can say angle 4 plus angle 5 is also equivalent to 180 degree because if we see on the another side, 4 and 5 both are interior angles and their sum becomes 180 degree. So that we can say that whenever interior angles lie on the same transversal line, on the same side they are lying, then we can say their sum becomes supplementary or their sum becomes 180 degree. So with the help of this concept, with the help of this diagram, we will identify different types of angles. It may be corresponding angles, it may be alternate interior angle, alternate exterior angle. Interior angles lie on the same transversal line, corresponding angle, and adjacent angles also. And one more angle, if you see, if we add angle 1 and angle 2, both are adjacent to each other, their sum becomes 180 degrees. So that concept is also related with linear pair. As I told earlier about the concept of linear pair, we can say angle 1 plus angle 4 is also the concept of linear pair. Same for this line M also, angle 5 plus angle 8, when we will add, their sum becomes 180 degrees. Same for angle 6 and 7. So with the help of this concept, angle made by a transversal, we will identify so many concepts that is related with corresponding angle, vertical opposite angle, alternate interior angle, alternate exterior angle due to the Z shape, as I told earlier, and one more concept, that is interior angles lie on the same transversal line. So one of the important concept, angle made by transversal, and it is possible only when L is parallel to M. If L is not parallel to M, then we can't identify such type of angles. Now after this, we will continue with some questions related with these concepts. So for example, if I am drawing two lines here, this is L line and this is M line, and one transversal line is there that is related with M. If this angle is 100 degree, then we have to identify about angle X, and if L is parallel to M, then how can we will identify the value of X? I am repeating again, L and M both are parallel. If this angle is 100 degree, then how can we will identify angle X? So in such type of the question, how can we will give the answer? If you see here, this angle is 100 degree, then what about this angle? For example, this angle is Y. Take this angle as Y. So we will say angle Y equals to 100 degree due to corresponding angle property. As I told earlier, in heading corresponding angle, if you see 100 degree lie above the line M, and angle y is also lie about the line L. So we can say angle y equals to 100 degrees, then we will write out the region. And if we see here, angle x plus angle y, after this we can say it becomes 180 degree. The sum of these two angles, why the sum of these two angles is equal to 180 degree? Because if you see here, we will continue with the concept of linear pair. Both angles are adjacent to each other. Now we will put the value of angle y, that is 100 degree, equals to 180 degree. By transfer method we can say angle x equals to 180 degree minus 100 degree, it becomes 80 degree. So whenever lines are parallel, we will easily identify the value of unknown angle as you see in this example. So I hope with the help of this explanation part, it is very much clear to all of you what is the meaning of pair of lines, what is the meaning of transversal, and how can we will identify different types of angles. There are so many questions are given in NCERT book. We will go with that. Thank you very much.